girls. How is everybody today?
Hi, kids. It's good to see you all here this morning. Hi, Susanna.
Howdy, everybody. Happy Epiphany.
And happy Epiphany to you, too.
So, it's a whole new year. We've celebrated Christmas and the birth of the baby Jesus. So what's next?
Well, I'll tell you what's next. We're talking about the baptism of Jesus this morning, and that's what's happening. And we're also having a baptism.
You know, that's something I just don't understand.
What?
Why Jesus needed to be baptized. Wasn't he already God?
That is exactly what John thought.
John?
Yes. John the Baptist. When Jesus came to John the Baptist to be baptized, John said, "What are you doing here? I shouldn't be baptizing you. You should be baptizing me." Okay, let's see. Okay, see? It's in this Bible that I have right here somewhere.
Exactly. I mean, God made water. Why would he need to be splashed with it?
So what did Jesus say to John?
He said one of his Jesus-isms. You know those lines that sound really amazing, but that are also kind of hard to figure out exactly what they mean.
Yeah, huh?
Well, it says here, in reply to John, Jesus said, "Let it be so now, for it is proper for us in this way to fulfill all righteousness."
I know. Sometimes when you break complex sentences into smaller parts, they make more sense.
Ooh, that sounds good to me.
Okay, first, so it said, Jesus said, "Let it be."
At least that part sounds familiar.
"Let it be so now, for it is proper for us," but us, who's us?
Well, maybe he means me, myself, and I,
or the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost.
"Let it be so now, for it is proper for us in this way."
This way? What way?
Jesus' way. Ah, Jesus is the way.
"Let it be so now, for it is proper for us in this way to fulfill all righteousness." Righteousness. As when everything is in its perfect place. I'm still not getting it.
I know.
You do?
Yes, I've always felt that if you don't understand something, you should try acting it out. That's what I do. To be or not to be, that is the question. Whether 'tis nobler to suffer the slings and arrows of this outrageous fortune, or to take arms against a sea of troubles, and by opposing end them.
What?
Hamlet. I'm acting Hamlet as a demonstration of my technique.
Okay, I get it. Suzanne, you be Jesus. Olivia, you be John. And I'll narrate and be the bird at the end. Then, Jesus. Then, Jesus came from Galilee to John at the Jordan to be baptized by him. John would have prevented him, saying,
"Stop! I need to be baptized by you. And you come to me?" Oh, I get it!
Wait, John doesn't shout, "I get it."
No. I mean, I actually get it. Acting out did help.
But we just started.
Yes, but don't you see? John says to Jesus, "I need to be baptized by you, and do you come to me?" That's the point, of course. Jesus comes to us. He comes to all of us, in the water, in our baptism. Here at church, at home, at work, Jesus comes to us. children who desperately need him to hold us and to love us and to be with us and us with him. And that's why he went to John and why he was baptized, because it's all one, all perfectly in the right place, all righteous.
Can we get back to the play? Because I like being Jesus.
Okay. So, Jesus went to John to be baptized, and John would have prevented him saying,
I need to be baptized by you, and do you come to me?
But Jesus answered him,
let it be so now, for it is proper for us in this way to fulfill all righteousness.
And John consented. And when Jesus had been baptized, suddenly the heavens were opened, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove. And alighting on him. And a voice from heaven said, this is my Son, the Beloved, with whom I am well pleased.
Now
was that a great day or what?
Royce Wilkinson.